in London. Thank you for lending us your voice on this day, because we have none. Our roars used to cut across the plains. It used to make our praise tremble, but today our grunts lie silent. Our numbers are declining. You hardly find us in the wild, but you find us scattered across the country, locked up in cages. We are broken. The ones you used to call kings have lost their crowns. Until now, there has been little justice in our world. We have seen our brothers, our sisters, our mothers, our fathers, our sons and daughters disappear. And we know that we will never see them again. We shall never taste freedom. We shall never roam the plains. Never shall we be queens and kings on future prides. Because there is no pride. There is no pride in killing a cornered animal. There is no pride in killing a drugged animal. There is no pride in breeding an animal for the bullet. And there is no pride in killing an animal that was raised to trust people. However, there is hope. There is hope because you are all here today. There is hope because in a year since the last Global Global March for Lions last year, so much has happened. Campaign Against Cat Hunting went from being a South African organization to going global. You have heard about Australia just announcing that it will ban the import of lion trophies. Yeah. Yay. 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 Leave you a very horrible lion park got exposed in the newspaper for being linked to cat hunting and selling carcasses of lions to Asia. Lion Park, another horrible lion farm, got featured in 60 Minutes in the States, which gained more than 18 million viewers. And then we have the story of Yama and George, you know, the two cubs that we saved from cub hunting, and now they're living happy lives in South Africa. In the lion country. So I want to say thank you to all of you. I want to say thank you for being here, and I want to say thank you for being a voice for the lions. And whatever you do, keep causing an uproar. Yeah.